Bar. Can I do for you?
The experience that the players went through last year, going through this week and preparing for the Sweet 16, is that helpful? I imagine it has to be helpful going into this time.
Well, I think it's helpful somewhat, but you know, we'll be familiar with Gonzaga a little bit. They'll be familiar with us. So I think it equals itself out. You know, but every game takes on a different personality. You can't really rely on what happened in another game sometimes. So what we got to do is just go out and just stay with the same formula that we've used to get to this point. You know, we're trying to just play as close as we can to our potential, be who we are. And this time of year, not very many people are going to change their system. And we're just going to try to go out and hopefully our system will be enough for us to be the advance.
I know last year, Killian Tilly was a late scratch before the game with the hip injury. Now he's back. Does that make them a little more difficult, especially up in the front court with a little more depth now?
Well, you know, we've been without injured players all year long. Phil Kofa had a stress fracture, and we played 11 games without him. He's our most experienced player. We don't have him here. I'm sure it affected their team, just like I'm sure not having Phil and not having David Nichols, two of our players, will affect our team. But at this particular point, those things you can't even have a conversation about because that you give in to them. We just got. I'm sure they. He's a very, very good player, and he'll make them stronger. And we have to find a way to make up for the guys that we don't have.
With five teams in the ACC that are in the Sweet 16, does that give special pride for the conference? And I mean, how does that kind of prepare you guys for playing top-notch caliber competition?
Well, I think we're prepared because we play against great competition against each other in the ACC. Now, you know, the ACC is one of the most rich traditional conferences in the history of college basketball, and I'm sure that all the ACC nation is excited about the teams participating in the NCAA tournament. But when they throw that ball up, I don't think any of them want to be having any thoughts about anybody. In other words, the level of competition that it takes when you get to the Sweet 16 is such where the only thing you got to worry about is going out and playing as well as you can to put yourself in the best position to advance.
What do you say about the way Raekwon has stepped into an expanded role over the last week or so?
Well, obviously, Raekwon has been making improvements all year long. I think you guys seen him growing up in front of our eyes.
Leonard, have you had a senior trio as close or gone through as much ups and downs as Terrence, Phil, and Chris?
Well, there's no doubt that we've had challenges with this bunch. A lot of injuries, a lot of development and stuff now with Phil's tragedy. But that's part of, unfortunately, that's part of what we deal with as coaches. You got to try to give them the tools to deal with challenges. That's what, you know, life, it would be wonderful if life was just without challenges. And hopefully, you don't ever prepare yourself for a situation that the Kofa family is going through. I'm just hoping that we've done the very best we can preparing our kids for challenges that they have to overcome in order to move on.
This is a team that seems very businesslike. They go about their business. When you are back on campus, people hold these guys in high regard. Is this a particular group that's enjoyable to coach?
Well, once again, you know, we have a culture development with our team where we hold each other accountable. We have responsibilities that we try to live up to. And that's kind of who we are. That's why I think we're where we are in terms of a program, is that our kids are responsible. We have five seniors. They're all going to graduate. They're all putting themselves in a position where they can be successful. But that's part of what you have to do as a coach, take all those responsibilities seriously and do the best you can with trying to develop them.
A lot of attention on their big guys. Defensively, though, it's on your guards as much as anybody else to help kind of slow down other teams' big men, right? I mean, from a system standpoint.
Well, in this particular game, they got two of the best shooters you ever want to see. So you can't give too much attention to the big guys because they have great shooters and the point guard. This Perkins is extremely experienced. They just happen to have two pogo sticks, but they have three post guys that they rotate, and the best guy probably comes off the bench. You know, he's a 6'11 guy, Tillis, who shoots threes, and so he's a tough matchup for anybody. This is a very good basketball team. Very similar to a lot of the teams we face in the ACC.
You mentioned Nichols earlier. Do you think you're not going to have him?
I think he's doubtful. at best. He was doubtful. But he didn't get in any practice today, and he was moving a little gingerly. And so we're moving on. Unless he has an unbelievable recovery, I'm not encouraged.
Last week you guys went up against Ja Morant. Where does Rui Hachimura and Brandon Clarke kind of rank in terms of some of the best players?
It was a different kind of situation with Morant because he wasn't surrounded with the level of talent that Gonzaga has. And, so it's kind of hard to really put them in the same category because Gonzaga has five guys in either position, but six guys that are capable of going off of big numbers.